Alright, what is up, guys? I should be running here. Sorry for the delay. Tomb Raider 1 apparently is almost impossible to get to run on Windows 10. Actually, it's not almost impossible, but it's really weird to set it up. But here we go. There's all kinds of methods of running it in on modern computers, so I had to do a bit of experimenting. Oh, goodness. Okay, I think I got it. Oh, man. A disaster. So, yeah, it is the 20th anniversary of the original Tomb Raider's release on... See, what was it on? It was on PC, of course, and it was on PlayStation. I think it even came to Sega Saturn, I want to say. I think I came to the game kind of late. In fact, I think I played a demo for Tomb Raider 2 before I played Tomb Raider 1. I played like a PC demo of Tomb Raider 2 and was like, oh, this is pretty cool, actually. People have been talking about it for a while. And, I was like, well, the first one's been out for a while, so let's buy the first one. And yeah, it was super cool. At the time, it was like really groundbreaking. In terms of exploration, and in terms of its 3D technology that it was using at the time. I'm gonna save pretty often because earlier I was just like alt tabbing out of the program and it would crash like instantly. So it's a bit buggy, a bit crashy on Windows 10. But so I'm not actually running. Well, I guess it's running through DOSBox, but I'm actually running. N-Glide, I think is what it's called, and it's basically a way to 3D accelerate a lot of classic old games. So, the original game actually ran in 256 color and at 320 by 240, I want to say. So it looked nothing like this. This is running in... 1080p, but in the correct aspect ratio, and I think it's 16-bit color. Ms. Croft is very violent. She pretty much kills everything unprovoked. And actually, when I first played this game, it was on the old family computer, which was had a dying monitor at the time, so everything was incredibly dark. And, so it seems like almost every time I play this game, I get a little bit more out of it than before because I see new things, or I play it in a different resolution. And because when I first played it, it was quite a challenge just to complete the game. In fact, oh! That's why I usually kill those guys before I come down here. Yeah, this is one of my favorites growing up. It was a lot of fun. It's funny though how poorly it's aged. graphics wise, it's okay, but the control scheme has just really poorly aged. But the guys at Core did a great job with animation. Drop down and fight this guy one on one. Oh, that was easy. Yeah, everything is just so slow and deliberate in its movements. Whenever you have a button to turn around, that's when you know your controls are a little bit clunky, a little tank-like. Not to say that there aren't good games with controls like that. This is an example. Resident Evil 4 has a button to turn around, so that's an example too. Oh yeah, and that just takes me out here. These first four levels were by far my most played. I just loved the progression. It starts you off very slow. You have just your basic pistols as a weapon. I think you get a shotgun in a couple of levels. I think the Lost Valley is the first time you get the shotgun. So it just kind of eased you into things. It really gave you a good starting ground for, how you should treat the game in terms of like it's a lot about exploration. It's a lot about finding secrets, and not so much on combat. And the later levels, I just always felt like they were just very combat oriented. And of course the enemies get pretty weird. The Atlanteans, spoiler alert. Oh jeez, I forgot about these guys. I can still have fun playing the original game. Unadulterated old school graphics and everything, but I can totally see that any newcomer to the Tomb Raider universe would not necessarily want to start with the first game. The new games are really good. I haven't played Rise of the Tomb Raider, but I played the 2013 Tomb Raider, and I liked it quite a bit. I think it was a little bit heavy on quick time events or events of their ilk, but it was still a really cool game. And of course, it controls miles better than the original games did, which was a huge plus. What is that thing? But as tedious and weird as the controls are in this game, it's like riding a bicycle. I can just pick it up right away. Of course, I played this a couple years ago. Played through just to. I was thinking about making a review about it or about Tomb Raider Anniversary and just never got around to it. But I did get footage. See, this is where timed puzzles like this, really strain the movement engine. Get in there! Oh yeah, I keep forgetting I'm picking up med kits, but you actually have to manually use them because they go in your inventory. So let's go ahead and save again. The later games, I think Tomb Raider 2, even as early as Tomb Raider 2, actually had a method of like turning around in midair. Like you could do a forward jump and then kind of flip around and turn around in midair. That's kind of cool. I've become so accustomed to the controls in this game that I can usually just kind of fly through jumps like that and not have to kind of line things up, but there's still the occasional jump that you just have to take your time, use the walk button, line things up. And then all the pickups, like, that was another complaint, even at the time, was like, just now, I stopped over that med kit, and I had to, like, very carefully position myself over it to pick it up. I guess I just go to the end now, right? I think I've gotten all the secrets. I'm actually a big fan of the Tomb Raider Anniversary game. Came out in 2006, so 10 years after the first game, and it's a complete sort of remaster, re-envisioning of the first game, and I thought it was really well done. Of course, it's based on the Tomb Raider Legend, like, engine, and how those games control. Oh, four of you guys. So the controls are quite a bit more fluid. And of course, 10 years later, the graphics are just, you know, a whole other level. And they actually still look pretty good, I think. I revisited that one a couple years ago as well. Single-shotting bats is pretty satisfying, to be honest. There's a bear in here somewhere. I think he comes out of here. Oh, oh, good job. Oh! Oh, he doesn't actually take that much damage. It's funny, like, when I was a kid, I thought, I was so scared of the bears. Like, oh man, here they come! But, you know, once you kind of get used to the controls, they're not too much of a challenge. It's funny, just simple things like grabbing onto ledges in a 3D platformer was, you know, not a given necessarily at the time that this came out. But this had a button to grab. There's a whole swarm of bats in here. I think there's one more wolf somewhere in this area. But it is funny how, oh man, how challenging this game was, and like dark this game was back in the day. And now I kind of feel like I can breeze through it. At least these first few levels, I know very well. Let's see, what is the save button? That's load. I'm guessing F5 save them. Yeah. Welcome Bamba. Left JJP. The bears in Red Dead Redemption are brutal by comparison, yeah. I haven't gotten that far yet in Red Dead. Let's see, should I go? I think I'll go this way. I think there is a switch to throw. Thank you. Am I wrong? I thought there was a switch. Maybe it's harder to see. Well, I know there's a switch over here, yeah. Run out of air, get out of there. I'm actually currently working on the next video for the channel that's not a live stream or a let's play or anything, and it will be Tomb Raider focused in honor of the 20th anniversary of its release. Yeah, I swear there's another switch somewhere in here that I am missing. And I thought it was right along one of these pillars. Ah, there it is. Yeah. Memory serves. Now if I can just get over here in time. This game hit a sweet spot in the 90s for some reason. I feel like early to mid 90s, everyone was all about like ancient Egypt. Is that still true? I don't know. But I know I was like totally obsessed with ancient Egypt, and like half of the kids' games that were kind of packaged in our family computer were like based around ancient Egypt stuff. So I don't know what it was, but it's like, yeah, that and it was just the right time for some new game like this that would that could explore those kind of environments. And in 3D, I mean, it was a huge deal. In 3D! It's like you're really there. What's up, Josh the NES nerd? Welcome to the chat. Anybody in the chat's played the latest Tomb Raider, Rise of Tomb Raider? Anybody? I've heard very good things, but I guess it's still an Xbox exclusive, so definitely cuts out a large part of the large part of their market. That was so tricky back in the day. Until you learned the controls. The terrible controls. And then this is like, oh man, artificially makes the game just like that much longer, having to move these blocks around. Let's see if that color change happens. Oh, it doesn't happen in this. Wow. So in the original game, like without 3D acceleration, oh, here it goes. Boom, yeah. But somehow that you push this block into the light and it just lights up immediately. I remember that. And I hear some more bats. Get the little idol, which is a sprite. And is there anything over here? Yes, a key. Kind of important. Josh the NES nerd says, this week I played through the first Doom with the Brutal mod really hard. Yeah. It definitely ups the difficulty level to what I feel like is more of a reasonable modern difficulty, given the advantages that you have with the mod, you know, aim down sights and more powerful weapons, The assault rifle is more powerful. I never saw this when I was a kid playing this game because it was just so dark. Oh, look at this. Get off of my brain. Get off of my dome. Oh, another bat. Man, they're all over the place. It's not something that many people mention, but this game really had very huge environments for the time. And that was kind of impressive. So not just that it was 3D, but... Oh! Nope, don't give up. Get it. This guy's sleeping. See, back in the day, I wouldn't have even seen that wolf in the distance until I was right up on top of him just because of the resolution. You started on ultraviolence. Yeah, ultraviolence, I mean, in the original Doom, it's pretty challenging. And on Brutal Doom, it's... I feel like it's a little bit tougher, but, you know, then again, you do get certain advantages, like I mentioned. Oh! Yeah! Yeah, a strong, positive female role model that murders animals. It's pretty awesome. What does everyone think about the movies, the Tomb Raider movies? I thought they really dropped the ball on them. Because the first Tomb Raider game, I mean, if you read the manual and understand her backstory, it's kind of interesting. Like, it's something about, like, her plane crashes in the Andes or something, and she has to learn to survive from that experience, and then she goes on to do adventures and all that kind of stuff. But I was just like, why are they doing some kind of comic book like thing when they could do this sort of gritty, realistic survival adventure story? I don't know. And then maybe mix a little bit of Indiana Jones-esque treasure hunting in with it. Oh yeah, so you can run and jump and get this. Just avoid all those blocks. Well, what should I do here? I guess I'll just go over here. Man, the controls are just so finicky. Was it, oh, you know what? You know who was in one of the original Tomb Raider movies? Original Tomb Raider movies. One of the Tomb Raider movies. Daniel Craig. Not many people remember that. But yeah, he did that. And now he's being offered an exorbitant fee to play Bond one more time. Or I guess for a few more movies. Oh yeah. Hold up. These can get a little dangerous. Whoops. Especially when your jump skills just like crap out on you. Yeah. And then you're in this situation, you could back up and then go back forward. Okay, yeah. They just made every effort to make the controls as tedious as possible. But at the time, it was just something you accepted because the game was so different and new and interesting. And I hear a bear. Whoops. In this case, maybe I'll do a sidestep if I remember what button it is. There we go. Yeah, so Tomb Raider was released on the PlayStation way back in the day, 1996, and at the time, like, I actually read a quote from IGN a few days ago, because I was doing some research for my next video, and IGN said, like, it's you know, PlayStation's answer to Mario 64, which is, that really puts it in context, you know. And it also kind of shows, like, PlayStation was going to be the sort of this more adult console. Oh, I'm going to die. Oh, I just did. Nope. Oh. Whoops. Death animations have always been a part of Tomb Raider, an important part of Tomb Raider. And man, in the new games, they brought those back so hardcore. They are so brutal and like gory almost. Ugh. But it's an important part. But yeah, Tomb Raider was released on PlayStation. It was a big deal. And I don't actually know why Tomb Raider never came to something like the N64. I don't think technologically it was outside of the realm of possibility. I mean, yeah, you have like CD music in this game, but a lot of it was just like ambient sound effect type stuff. It was probably just a licensing thing. Okay, I'm gonna try to stay up here and take this guy out. Lovely camera. Left JJP asks, better death animation than GoldenEye. No, not really. The interesting thing about the animation in this game, though, is that it's all hand keyframed, whereas in GoldenEye, they actually... okay, that's not really useful to me. In GoldenEye, they actually went through and did motion capture, which is super common practice today, of course, but back in... You know, the 90s, motion capture for video games was, I don't think it was really that commonplace. And the animation in this game is really good. Like, they really made an effort to kind of give you a sense of momentum. But why... Oh, why did they do this? I mean, really? Did you guys have to spend a few days animating that and... Oh, wrong way. And programming that into the game? Oh, here we go. Lost Valley, man. Lost Valley. Probably my favorite level in the original Tomb Raider. And it's always fun to start it like this. Dun 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 dun. Wee. Leap of faith. Ow! Ah! Yeah, this level was really cool, for me at least, personally, at the time, because, like I said, my monitor was, like, super dark back in the day, and I just could not figure out where to go initially in this game. So I explored this upper, like, river area for, oh man, there's three of them down here? God, give me a break. Well, yeah, I explored this, like, upper river area for hours. I mean, I want to say it was like 2 or 3 hours. Just having no idea where I'm going, what I'm supposed to do. And then I finally came down here and was kind of going through this wolf's den for the 100th time. And then I looked over here and, oh, that block is flat on top. Oh wait, I can keep going. Holy crap. Oh, cool. It's a little secret. I can get a mecha. Oh, wait a second. What was that? Oh, snap. Greenery. And a completely different area of the level. I mean, that was cool enough. Like, wow, that's cool. It was like kind of this hidden area. And then you get some dinosaurs. And you lose your mind because you're a 12-year-old kid, and dinosaurs are the coolest thing ever. And they still are, by the way. But yeah, so, you know, dinosaurs, freaking ancient Egypt. You really couldn't go wrong with Tomb Raider. And just the ambience of everything. The music, or kind of lack thereof, and the darkness and the hidden valley. Like, this was really, really cool back in the day. And it's still kind of cool. But the other thing was, like, I mean, it doesn't look like it now because the resolution, like, this is running at 1080p. It's very crisp. And you can see, like, everything going on. It's not really much of a mystery, but, like, at the time, the resolution was just on that edge where, like, you would look at a wall and you couldn't really tell, like, what was a, you know, what was a grotto, what was a secret, and what was just, like, a detail. Oh, I guess I gotta prepare myself here. Should probably save, because you know what's happening next. Ah! Most epic animal in any game at the time. Ah, jeez! You know what? I'll let him eat me. Whee! That was so cool at the time, man. So cool. Yes, Lara Croft is Turok, Dinosaur Hunter. It was like, Turok was more of a title, right? Like, there were several Turoks throughout the games, I believe. Alright, now let's dance with this mofo! Clap, 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 clap! I believe you could get a shotgun before this if you went up the river valley, but oh! Oh, that's a bad position. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Nowadays, this looks very crude and low poly. But this was really cool back in the day. And it's still kind of cool, let's be honest. And this valley, you know, is not a huge area, but it's just packed full of secrets and cubby holes all over the place. Just looking at this wall, I can see at least two, actually three. It's pretty cool. Still fun to go back and revisit. I'll try to catch up with the chat here. A Turok video should happen. Yeah, Turok. I haven't touched on Turok, and that was kind of a big franchise. Especially for the N64, of course. Oh, should I lower myself down there? That was close. Josh, the NES nerd, says, wasn't there a fan-made port of Turok to modern PCs? You needed a ROM of the 64 game for it to work. I'm not sure if there was a fan-made port, but actually, at the time, if you remember, Turok 1, and I believe even Turok 2, had PC ports, like, at the time. And they ran with 3DFX cards, so like Voodoo cards. So there were legit ports at the time. Later on, though, like, because they were... You know, that era of games is hard to get running these days on, like, modern computers. Later on, I'm not sure if there was a fan-made port, but just about a year ago, maybe, or maybe even more recent than that, a little company called Night Dive Studios, I think Night Dive Studios is the name of the company, made a new port of Turok 1 for PC, and it... supposed to you know, run brilliantly and be a sort of perfect one-to-one port with, you know, high res graphics, but I don't think they did anything to the textures, you know, that kind of thing. So it is available, and I think it was like $20 or something at the time, which sounds a little steep to me for such an old game. Just straight up ported. It's not like a remaster. It was just a straight up port. Can I get up there? Huh. I don't remember what to do there. That may be where that empties out, where that bridge leads to. I'd be willing to bet on that. Still more climbing to do. Apparently you can access her basement in a later game, and there's a T-Rex head mounted on her wall. That's pretty awesome. Yeah, I seem to remember Turok. Now I'm completely mixed up. Seem to remember Tomb Raider 2 having like a much larger mansion that you could explore, and I think they had like a secret room in the basement of the mansion. And with, I mean, every subsequent game, it seemed like they added more and more detail into the mansion. I always thought that was a cool part of the game. I'm using N-Glide, and it was a little bit of a challenge to set up. It's a little bit unstable on my system for whatever reason. Initially, when I was setting it up and starting to do some test recordings, it would crash, like, every time I would task switch, so... But it seems to be doing good now. I'm just gonna try not to task switch. Oh. Ah! She's got ups, man. Jump right over these raptors. know, this is only 3 years after the first Jurassic Park, so, like, people were still crapping their pants over dinosaurs. I feel like people are a little more jaded now. Yeah, Josh the NES Nerd mentions, I wish I could have experienced the generations where some console ports could sometimes be a totally different game. Yeah, isn't that true? I mean, like, I was reading about Quake 2, or maybe it was Quake 1, back in the day. You know, id made Quake 1, obviously. But then, like, the ports were handled by completely different companies. I think a different company did the port for N64. And then another company did the port for Saturn, I want to say. Or maybe it was even Dreamcast. Okay, now I'm a little confused. Did I go in there? Or did I go in there? And I think I can get up in that little pocket up there. Let's see where this goes. This game still seems pretty packed full of secrets, to be honest. Okay, so I did this one. I think I may be missing stuff already. I can't even tell you how many times I've played this level. Well, nothing up there. Already got the cog up there, so let's just pass through this. Oh, and Quake 2 on N64 was a totally different map set. Wow. Yeah, I've never played that one. Those games have pretty interesting history. Okay, this looks promising. Yeah, I remember this. There's another raptor in here. Shooter! Shooter! That's a weird little placement of Inca type graphics. So, there's really nothing in here? Like, what the heck? There's no pickups or anything in this little spot. But you know what? That's part of the fun. It's like you're exploring and there's just random areas everywhere. And it feels more organic, to use that incredibly overused word. But you don't get that with too many games these days, I feel like. Alright, did I do that little... Yeah, I think that was empty. Nothing in there. It was also, you know, it was always kind of ambiguous, like, could I get on top of this slanted brick? And sometimes it didn't look like you could, but you could, and... There we go. And jumps were sometimes, you know, you had these, like, off-kilter jumps that were strange to make when the game is so obsessed with this grid system. Whee! This is a pretty valuable secret. Got a bunch of ammo for all kinds of different things. No extra guns, though. This game was also incredibly for as big as some of the areas are, it still feels incredibly claustrophobic because, I mean, they're basically just big caves. Like even in this valley, it still just feels like a big cave because it's all just dark on the sky. I just felt like all the, environments of this game were interior, even if they weren't technically supposed to be or supposed to feel like that. But the second game went way more open with the environments, lots of vistas. Think the last cog is in here. Okay, nothing else in here. One thing I hate about the Tomb Raider Anniversary, they did so much right in Tomb Raider Anniversary in terms of building up the worlds again and making them, similar but different and just making them really pretty. But when they did Lost Valley, it was like, okay, here we go, Lost Valley, favorite level. They made the T-Rex into like a boss fight, and I just thought it was like so overdone. Like, just let me organically kind of come into the situation. Like, I'm creeping around a corner and oh crap, here's the freaking T-Rex. But no, they made it a cinema scene and a boss fight, and I just didn't appreciate that. All right, so oh, I guess I should have checked my inventory to make sure I have all three. Yes, I do. The advantage of knowing the solution to the puzzle before you even see the puzzle. I just went ahead and skipped all that stuff. Now, if you screw up these jumps, you get washed all the way down the river, so I don't want to do that. Oh, jeez. Back in the day when you had to calculate everything based on blocks. Surprised I didn't dream in blocks when I first played this game. And here we are. Let's see, should I go? All right, well, I'll turn the machine on first and then I think I can go get that other secret there. Thank you, Nightbot. Yes, if you're enjoying this stream, please like and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. And share. And comment. I appreciate that, sir. The Wii came out when I was 8. I turned 18 3 days ago. I feel old. You feel old? Oh, man. I love that animation. Nothing, like, the cogs that you just put in don't even move. They're just like, okay, we gotta start building the next level. Let's just, come on. Neat. Oh, I can't climb out. Oh, I'm glad I turned on the machine before I did that then. All right. This is cool. Skeleton with shotgun. It's kind of a modern sort of idea. In fact, in Tomb Raider 2013, the first weapon you get is a bow, and you totally pull it off of a skeleton. It's pretty cool. I wonder if that's a deliberate callback or if it's just kind of makes sense in the survival horror sort of genre. And if you haven't played the new Tomb Raider, when I say new, I mean the 2013 Tomb Raider, it kind of does have that survival horror feel, like almost more so than like an adventure game. It's kind of crazy. But there's a lot of action, like a lot of gunplay. I have this feeling that it's been a long time since I saved, so I think I'm going to do that. F5. One of those handful of games that I've bought a couple of times. I try to avoid that and like to play things on original hardware, but sometimes Steam is just so attractive that I gotta just buy it again. So I think Steam had a deal a few years ago, like all the Tomb Raider games up through Chronicles or Legend or something like that. Like all these Tomb Raider games for really cheap. I'm gonna say like $20 or something crazy like that. So I was like, okay, I guess I'm buying a few of these again. Can I check how many secrets I have in this? I don't know if I can. Detail levels. It's a compass. Yeah, I love that there's a compass in this game that you never really, really need. All right, I think it's I can't tell how many secrets I've got, but I think I got them all. So, moving on to Koalopek. Conclusion of our dinosaur levels, I believe. It's the last time we see them in the whole game. I think so. Ah, go, 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 go. Oh, no. Even like stuff like that was so cool at the time. It's like, oh man, it's like Indiana Jones. Sweet. Which is essentially what her character is like. It's basically a female Indiana Jones. That's a little more trigger happy, I would say. Oh, there's two of these guys. Oh. Clever girl. I like to set off that rolling boulder. First thing in this level, because yeah. Otherwise, I forget about it and I end up getting rolled over at the very end. Now, this level had a few kind of interesting secrets that I may not remember how to get. Okay, so that was not the thing to do, I guess. Oh, wait, here's another push block. It's not totally obvious, is it, which ones are push blocks and which aren't. And you guys remember what this breakaway pit is?
Yep.
First spikes in the game, I guess. Unless you go down a different route, I guess, but... And the question is, how do I get across this gap? I guess I'll do a running jump. Yeah. The spikes were always one of those super cool things. Just like a classic Indiana Jones touch, you know. Obvious trap is obvious. Haha. Only one way to go. Pep, pep, pep. The cinema scenes kind of give this this game trouble on modern systems for some reason, but I guess we'll see what happens. Because it was crashing earlier a lot as it would change resolutions when you go from in-game. In-engine graphics to the cinema scenes. Oh man, those cinema scenes, dude. They're It's so funny to see them now because like they're like an interlaced, like a faux interlaced graphic. But that was like a technique at the time, I guess, to save on space or something. I don't know, but like mid 90s, like a lot of computer games had this sort of faux interlaced look. And I just always thought it was so terrible looking. It just looks dark. What does this do? Oh, yeah. The whole point of going down these pathways. Oh, and that poops me out onto the main area here. Now we go this way. Oh yeah, should I have done that now or? They're very light puzzle solving elements in this game. There were a few puzzles in the new game that I thought were pretty challenging. Oh, I guess I'm going this way. Josh the NES Nerd says, I guess the Indie Expanded Universe is still canon. I didn't even realize that there was an Indie Expanded Universe, to be honest, but yeah, I guess, like, are you talking about, like, the shows, like, the young Indiana Jones and stuff like that? Wait. What? Oh, I shouldn't have moved that yet. Oh, man. Let's see if I can still use it as a jump platform. I don't think I can. Oh, maybe. That's a pretty hard angle to hit, but maybe I can do it. Nope. It's okay. I opened that door anyway, so. Yeah, I was disappointed that, you know, Disney was like, okay, expanded universe, didn't happen. We need to control all this content. Which means, like, some of my favorite video games, like Star Wars video games, are, you know, not necessarily canon anymore. But, then I read this article, and I actually posted on the, Dumb Kinda Games Facebook page about how this sort of fan theory that's like Rogue One is kind of basically Dark Forces. And there are a few pretty good reasons for thinking that. The lead character's name, the female character, her name is almost like Jan Ors, who's the character in Dark Forces, the female character at least. And the other guy, the what looks to be the male lead, kind of was dressed up sort of Kyle Katarn-esque in the trailer. And so it's like, oh, well, maybe they're like the partner team that goes in, and they sort of seem like mercenaries, like they don't seem like rebels. Maybe that's the team that's going in to get the Death Star plans. And there's even like some evidence like of dark troopers in the trailer. So yeah, I'm excited. Oh, I can't wait. It's gonna be awesome. I just need to leap past this stuff. Oh, that didn't hurt. Wow. Oh, geez. Blam, blam, blam. Let's go ahead and save. You know, now that I think about it, I think there's only like two secrets in this level, and one is coming up here. Ah. And it's maybe up there. I'm going to guess it's over here. Funny, I didn't remember a door covering this thing up. Oh, whoops. Ow. Oh, jeez. Come on, controls. Cooperate. But I guess... yeah, this looks about right. Yeah. Anybody remember this? Back in the day, I had the Prima guide, the Tomb Raider. Oh yeah. This also had like an even like a sort of second part of the secrets. Oh man, I'm never gonna be able to do that. Like you can. Dang it. If you know how to do it, you can actually get down there, and there's another pickup down there. Like a second part of the secret. I think it still counts as the main secret, though. Let us see. That is incredibly close. And also, I'll save here. I do think there's a way to drop on it by, you know, hanging off of something like this, but It's got to be like pixel perfect. It's kind of ridiculous. Oh my gosh. Okay, there we go. Magnum ammo. Sweet. Oh, that hurt a little bit. Now into the throne room, presumably. Oh, that's kind of cool. Haha, that's really cool. I always thought this was really weird. First of all, I thought the mummies were weird anyway. But this one mummy in particular, she aims at... I think it's actually even, like, making blood spots on it. Yeah. I just thought that was so weird. Like, what is the point of this? Anyway, let's do the epic thing here. I think I'll save it. Run away! Oh wait, how do I get out? Did I miss something? Oh. Nope. Already dealt with that boulder, so I should be good. As long as I don't get smashed here. Jump over that rubble. Da 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 da. Oh yeah, I'm taking damage already because the dude's shooting at me. Secret number two, I think. Okay, let's go kill old boy. He's pretty easy once you just learn the technique of staying behind him. Because they apparently have tank controls as well.
Well, you have my total attention now. I'm not quite sure if I've got yours, though. Hello?
I'll heal and hide you to a barn door yet.
Of course.
You and that driveling piece of the Skion, you want to keep it so bad? I'll harness it right up your...
Wait. We're talking about the artifact here?
Damn straight we are, right up.
Hold on. I'm sorry. This piece, you say, where's the rest?
Miss Natler put Pierre DuPont on that trail.
And where is that?
Ha! You ain't fast enough for him.
So you think all this talking is just holding me up?
I don't know where his little jackrabbit frog legs are running him to. You'll have to ask Miss Natalie.
Thank you. I will.
Blam! Uh-oh. Yeah, it's weird. It runs this in a... window for some reason. But I don't want to touch anything, just like let it go. I don't know if you can see it in the live stream, but it's just so weird. I mean, it's low res, interlacy looking video. Let's see, I've been going for little over an hour. I think I'll do this next map and probably call that. But this next one is quite a long level, and I actually don't know it all that well. But we'll see what happens.
Pendant divided and shared between the three rulers, which curbs tremendous powers. Powers beyond the creator himself. My toes sweat at such possibilities, lying so close to my mortal self. Each night, I beat myself rid of these fantasies, but it is indeed a test.
Pierre, you litterbug.
All right, let's see if this boots up the level just fine without crashing. Oh, weird. Okay, cool. I think it did it. Ah, and I'm already getting attacked. Oh, no, it didn't do it. Something visually off here. Oh, the camera seems weird. It's like the something didn't work right. I'm gonna save and oh, there we go. That fixed it. There we go. That looks much more accurate. Okay, cool. Let us keep going here. Have I ever played the Dude mod for Doom? No, I haven't played it. I'm trying to think of what it is. Is that the one that, like, mirrors the screen? So you have, like, two of each weapon, or it's, like, two pistols, and it does this weird, like, I don't know, mirroring effect? I feel like I saw Icarus Lives review that mod, and I was like, why would you want to play that? It didn't look fun at all. Oh, let's use a shotgun on these guys. These are a little bit tougher. Oh, maybe not. Ah, blam. Maybe I'm misremembering the power of the shotgun. Does that seem pretty effective? What did that do? You know, what a quaint idea to have a switch that activates something, but they don't, you know, explicitly tell you what it was that it activated. That's a very old-school idea. But some modern games just get, like, too concerned with feeding you information. Oh yeah, I gotta fight this Pierre guy here. Where is he at? And he runs away, filled with bullets. Okay, so that opened that. Can I move it now? And it will still be open? I think I can. Right? Yeah. Oops. You just hope you don't do that when you're, you know, five stories up on something. All right. Can I do it at this angle? I don't know. Yeah. Of course I can. Here's one of the hardest secrets in Tomb Raider coming up here. I don't know if I remember how to get it, so I may just need to give up on it, but some way you can get up there. And I think it's kind of tricky. Alright, let's do a save. Yeah, you gotta hit that ramp high enough. Yeah! But also, like, far enough, like, deep enough, I guess. Can't do a backflip either, because that just gets you... Oops. Can't do a sideflip either. I don't know what I'm supposed to be aiming for here. Dang it. I remember spending quite a bit of time trying to get this right the first time I played it. Oh my gosh. Let go of jump. Riveting live stream content. Get it! Get it! Oh, man. Maybe I should try to do the center here and do that. No. Last time I played this, I got up there, but... Let's see, what if I forward jump here, backflip... But I guess I can't really change my angle that much if I do that. Let's see. Forward... Backflip! No, I can't. Oh, there we go. Yeah, there we go. Oh, and then I gotta do another one of these freaking things. Okay. Ah, that's a little more straightforward. And I get a couple of shells and a large medkit, which I don't really need, but hey. Getting all the secrets, man. Getting all the secrets. I don't know if it makes sense to drop from this. So I will. Oh, yeah. Let's see. Oh, wait. Can I get that from that pillar? I think maybe I can. I don't quite remember where the best place to jump from is, but I feel like I can get this, yeah. Let's save it, because I don't really want to fall. Oh! Yeah, that kind of hurt. And load. On PlayStation, you had to pick up specific, like, save point crystals. Yeah. Which was a pain. But that was how you did it on the consoles for most games. But on the flip side, the PC game was kind of tortured by the fact that you could... very easily, like, instant save in, like, mid-fall, and it would be, like, terrible. So you'd have a permanently destroyed save file. You just had to be careful with it. How did your channel go from Bamnation to Dome Candy? Yeah, but, I was calling it Bamination Games because Bamination was my sort of gamer tag in a lot of games, specifically like Battlefield. And then, oh, this is a secret as well. Let's see, how do I do this? I think I have to go down backwards. But then when I decided to actually start making like content that wasn't just you know, replays and stuff like that, I decided to brand with something. And yeah, Dome Candy was what I came up with. And it's a little bit of an inside joke because the Nerf game that my friend and I would play back in the day, we would consider like headshots as Dome Candy. And so I was like, oh man, that really makes a lot of sense. But then I was like, oh, I could spin it as like Dome Candy in terms of, you know, video games are kind of like candy for your dome. I think it's an apt comparison. It's like if you have too many video games, then your brain just like rots out of your skull, right? Just like if you eat too much candy. It's perfect. It's awesome. Oh, that water lowered very quickly and very quietly. Alligators. Or crocodiles, I guess, in this case. In America, it's alligators, man. Gators! Or I think I saw an internet meme that called it an American death log. But that's pretty good. Now begins the epic room that takes a really long time, full of really weird traps. Basically, you gotta hit a bunch of switches to open all these doors based on Roman mythology, and then complete each like challenge in each door, which some of them are kind of difficult. There's a switch. So I'll go down here. I'm probably gonna die a bunch in this room just from like accidentally falling off of things. Actually, you know, this feels smaller than it is in Tomb Raider Anniversary. I feel like they beefed up the size of this room and made it a little more complex to traverse. Guess I'll go get that. I guess I'll go in Thor, because why not? It's right there. And there's Damocles. Okay. Save. I never understood how this room worked. I mean, it strikes the pads, right? Okay. But I can't run just like through the middle. I get like eaten alive. I don't know. Let's try that again. Yeah, I never got how this was supposed to work. this disco ball like lights your ass up and oh, that was weird. I don't know. Well, I got through it. I got plenty of medkits. Let's use a big one. I do remember this. Oh. Oh, yeah, it knocks this down. And of course, it knocks it down like 7 blocks away from the wall that I need it next to. And that's the thing with going back to this game. There's just. Pretty quickly, you realize just how tedious it is. It doesn't hold up as especially, you know, action-packed. Not to say it's not a good game, but, you know. Things like this just, like, slow the pace down so much. Climb that like a primate. Completely ran over this key here. Okay. Sweet. Yeah, so each room you get a different key in. I probably shouldn't try to jump down that. That looks pretty crazy. Oops. Whoops. Oops. Ha 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 ha. Whoops. Oh, man. See, that's the thing. Oh, sweet. I actually got past without incurring bodily harm. All right. I'm going to save after I do this freaking block. Yeah, I didn't really play many video games. Like, okay, so I didn't have a console growing up until N64. So by the time I got an N64, I was 12. But yeah, before that, like, I had a Game Gear as my first real like video game system. And I even, like, had a rationale. I was like, oh, yeah, well, the Game Gear is color, man. It's color. Game Boy is black and white. That was the fight that we used to have, you know, back in the day. Now people nitpick about, oh, the PS4 is a little bit more powerful than the Xbox One. That's nothing, man. We had color versus black and white. Oh, I didn't save it like I said I was going to. All right, let's save it. Now, I'm going to get murdered here. Yeah, I still don't know how that works. But I made it out with a single key. And I don't even remember what I opened before. See what's down here. Ah, good, another switch. Neptune, that's up top. And then I think there's a switch like on the ground floor. I'm getting shot at again. I think there is, so I think I'm gonna go ahead and drop down. Oops. Yep. Are you gonna fight back or just run away? Okay. You're gone. Did the Game Gear have blast processing? No, that's why you had to get the Genesis, man. But I remember when I was... I actually saved up for a Game Gear way back in the day. And it was like $120. And then you had to buy like $15 worth of batteries like every, you know, week. But at the time, the Genesis was pretty much the same price point, I want to say. It was like $130. Like, it was really close. But I was like, no, I want a portable system, blah, blah, blah. Oh, man. Really wish I would have gotten a Genesis or something, a Super Nintendo. In hindsight, I probably would have liked a Super Nintendo a lot better. Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis. Oh, did I pull that switch? I think I did. I hope I did. That would really suck if I forgot to do that. I messed that jump up really bad, but I somehow saved it. Okay, cool. Damocles is open, so I'm guessing we're good to go here. Wait, can I run through here? Oh, yeah. So these things don't fall until you exit the room. It's a weird level. I mean, it's full of these kind of... supernatural type... rooms. Oh, this isn't a secret. Wow. I'm surprised. Yeah, system power is a funny thing, because a lot of people seem to complain about Nintendo's philosophy. Of, you know, focus on the games, focus on the games. And I've kind of gotten tired of their whole shtick of, like, we must innovate all the freaking time. Rather than, you know, keep up with current standards in game graphics and such. But it's a complicated issue. Ah! Yes, the Sega Nomad. Oh, man. Yeah, after I got a Game Gear, I guess, you know, it was a few years later, the Nomad came out. I was like, oh, man, I could have had a Genesis in a portable system. And that's how fast technology was moving, even back then. I think the Nomad came out in, like, 94 or 95. And it was... I mean, the Genesis by that time actually was pretty old. It was released in 89. As the Master System. Where am I going? I guess I'm just going up. Yeah, I was quite envious of the Nomad back in the day. That's a pretty cool system. All right, Neptune. I don't know where the door for Atlas was, but I'm sure I'll find it eventually. These bats can be kind of jerks. They can end up knocking you off of ledges and stuff. Let's see here. I think this is straight up just like dive in the pool and go to the bottom. I think it's pretty straightforward, but you do have to be... Oops, kind of on your game. Do not load. Save. I think I'll dive in. That's a cool way to do it. Boosh! Jumping in pools like that was always, like, very intense in the early days of this game, because the resolution was so low that it was kind of hard to see, like, the details that you needed to see. Like, where are the switches? Where are these levers? When you're talking about, you know, a fraction of the resolution that I'm looking at here. So yeah, that was the key. I don't know what this door is even about. It's kind of weird. Inventory. Emptying them, please. I need to find the Atlas door. I have no idea where it is. But I must have opened it. Oh. Is that it down there? I don't know, mate. I don't know. I thought I've switched enough of the switches. Oh, Atlas. There it is. Boom. Yeah, here we go. I had a feeling this guy was in here. Let's go ahead and save. Okay, I remember this. I don't remember if that move can save you or not, but I think I'm gonna try it. Yep, let's go. Go, 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 go. Yeah. Sweet. And then the goods are up here. Maybe it'll just like run up and just climb up the wall straight away, but that's a cool way to do it too. Okay, now I just gotta get down to the bottom of the room here. But first I'm going to go to the top. And that's for a very specific reason. To get one of the crazier secrets in this game. A timed puzzle that I think is activated with that pressure pad there. And it opens that door. To see if that did it. Yep, it did open that door. Okay, cool. I think I need to run to the end of this and drop down and do that a couple of times and try not to get killed by the lions. Okay, cool. Let's save. And let's do a shotgun. Alright, here we go. Dun 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 da da da. Take a little damage. Oh! Oh! Oh, she died. They don't have an animation for her dying in mid-backflip, so... Oh, hi, cute kitty. I think I'll give her some health the next time I try that. Yep, just need a little bit more health. Should be good. Let's just do that. Ah! Get off of me. Oh man, the camera just like completely almost ruined everything. Alright. And all I get is a measly full medkit. I can't believe that's all that's in that secret. That is one of the craziest secrets, because you have to traverse so freaking far. And if you mess up, you basically have to spend like 20 minutes climbing back up. If you don't have a save game. Which, if you're on PlayStation, you probably wouldn't. Is this the right key? I don't know. I don't know what this is.
No.
No. Sidle over.
No.
No? Damocles! Cool, man, cool. Well, I think I'll call the stream here. Pretty good. Got through 5 levels without dying too much. And I think I got all the secrets in. Oh, I missed a secret. I don't know where that would be. I don't know. Got all the secrets except one through the first 5 levels. Cool. Go ahead and save it. And as soon as I alt-tabbed out of the program, it closed. Crashed. Didn't just close, it crashed. Anyway, thank you guys for watching today's live stream and participating in the chat. If you liked what you see, as always, subscribe, like, comment, whatever. Thanks again, and thanks for watching Dome Candy Games, because video games are like candy for your dome. I'll see you next time. Stay tuned to the Facebook page, the YouTube channel, for new live streams and new videos. Hopefully I will have another video soon. I want to say within a week. It's going to be a completely new kind of series. And I think it'll be pretty fun to see. So, yeah. Tune in next time. Later, y'all.